Grippers are important tools for picking and placing objects in modern assembly lines. Active grippers like the parallel jaw grippers or suction cups are widely used because of their versatility. However, they require additional programming and control instructions. Passive grippers have no actuation and rely on robot arms for their movement. In robotics, passive grippers have been gaining interest because they don't require extra planning. They don't require continuous power to maintain their state. They allow easier human interactions with the robot, and they reduce the system complexity and deployment cost. However, one limitation to the widespread use of passive grippers are the significantly restricted type of objects that can be grabbed. Some grippers are called passive because they passively conform to an object. They rely on some soft or elastic structures to squeeze an object. This type of grippers still require an actuator to release a grasp. Existing truly passive grippers are specialized for certain type of objects. This donut-shaped gripper can only grab cylinders or cones using a rotation motion. Motivating this work is the insight that rapid manufacturing and design optimization can be used to expand the space of shapes that can be passively grabbed. We present an algorithm that, given a target object and its positioning relative to the robot arm, generates a 3D printable passive gripper design and an accompanying insert trajectory that approaches the object without collisions. Designing these grippers requires addressing fundamental challenges. Firstly, the design space of the gripper is very large. And secondly, valid insert trajectories and object stability depend on the gripper design, making it an expensive nested optimization. We address these challenges with two key insights. Our first insight is that the points where the gripper makes contact with the object are essential for understanding the object's stability. We call this set of points the grasp configuration, or GC. We observe that we can determine whether or not an object is stable by only analyzing the GC. Next, we observe that at the end of the insertion, the gripper must touch the object at the given contact points, and the gripper must be a single solid object connecting the contact points with the robot arm. With this observation, our second key insight is that we can search for the insert trajectory by creating a low-dimensional gripper design abstraction that is minimal enough to satisfy such requirements. We call this design abstraction the skeleton. With these key insights, we can define a reducer space for passive grippers that involves finding a GC, a gripper skeleton, and an insert trajectory. Since a GC fully determines stability, one could find the GCs that maximize stability and then co-optimize the other two to ensure no collision. However, finding a valid insert trajectory for the best GC might not be possible, because the GC restricts the gripper design, which restricts the available trajectory. What we want is the most desirable GC such that there exists a valid insert trajectory. Our approach is therefore as follows. Given an input object and its positioning relative to the robot arm, our first step generates a list of stable GC candidates and ranks them based on the metrics we care about. Our second step takes the best ranked GC and co-optimizes the insert trajectory and the gripper design abstraction to avoid collision. If the algorithm could not find a valid insert trajectory, we would try the next GC candidate on the list. To improve the sturdiness of the gripper and to save materials, our last step runs topology optimization to generate the final gripper design. We first focus on the grasp configuration generation stage. Our gripper will contact the object at three locations, and so a grasp configuration will contain exactly three contact points. We choose three because it is a minimum number of contact points that constrains the rigid body. The GC generation step starts by identifying potential contact points. Next, multiple GC candidates are formed by randomly selecting three contact points. We then filter our undesirable GCs and rank them based on some metrics. Let us now focus on identifying potential contact points. For ease of illustration, consider this 2D object. To find potential contact points, we uniformly randomly sample points on the surface and remove points that are unreachable or occluded by the floor. Next, we repeatedly form a GC by randomly select three valid contact points. We then use two filters to remove undesirable GCs. Our first filter considers the stability of the object. Looking at these three examples, we can see that the object on the left is unstable because there is no upward support, where the two objects on the right can still be held stably. To identify GCs that are unstable, we use a metric called partial force closure, which determines if an object can be held stably under gravity. Formally, it checks whether there exists a non-negative linear combination of forces at torque by the contact points such that it counteracts the gravity. We can then remove unstable GCs from consideration. To save us time from finding trajectory for GCs that have no solution, our second filter removes GCs that have no valid insert trajectory. We use a fast optimization method that checks if it is possible for a GC to break contact with the object. Consider the GC on the right. We can see that there is no motion that breaks contact with the object without collision. Therefore, finding an insert trajectory for this GC is impossible, and so we can remove this GC from consideration. For the GC in the middle, one can rotate the GC to break contact with the object. Therefore, a valid insert trajectory for this GC may exist. Let us now focus on ranking the GCs. Our first ranking metric favors robustness to external disturbances. We use a metric called partial minimum range, which finds the minimum external force and torque that would destabilize the object. Larger partial minimum range is better. Our second ranking metric favors smaller and lighter gripper designs. GC whose contact points are closer to the robot arm, we have a smaller design footprint, and we have a higher chance of finding a valid insert trajectory because it interferes less with the object. We measure this by computing the length of the non-colliding path from the robot arm to the contact point. Having generated a ranked list of GCs, we now proceed to find the insert trajectory for the best ranked GC. In this stage, we co-optimize the gripper design and the insert trajectory to avoid collision. While co-designing is typically a challenging problem because of the large search space, we reduce it to an optimization over a low-dimensional space of parameters. Our gripper design abstraction, or skeleton, contains three fingers connecting the robot arm with each of the contact points. Each finger is represented as a piecewise linear segment connecting the joints. Intermediate joint positions are to be optimized. The insert trajectory is represented as a list of keyframes. Each keyframe is the state of the robot arm in joint space. Likewise, intermediate keyframes are to be optimized. Our objective function includes multiple components. First, we penalize the collision between the gripper and the object throughout the course of the insert trajectory. Second, we penalize the collision between the robot arm and the floor. And lastly, we penalize trajectories that are more complex. To identify collisions between the skeleton and the object, we leverage a ray tracing algorithm. We shoot multiple rays along the skeleton and see if they intersect. We then discretize the time along the trajectory and use ray tracing to check for collisions at each time step. However, when discretizing at low resolution, collisions through a narrow object will not be captured, and increasing the resolution can be costly. We therefore propose to also discretize the skeleton and shoot rays in the direction of the trajectory. We now perform the co-optimization that finds the gripper skeleton and the insert trajectory that minimize the objective function. A solution is found when there is no collision between the gripper skeleton and the object at any point along the trajectory. Technically, this optimized skeleton and the insert trajectory would serve as a working gripper. However, it cannot be fabricated and cannot withstand heavy payload because it is too thin. Our last step performs topology optimization to obtain a fabricable and sturdy gripper. A slight modification needs to be made because not all voxels can be part of the final gripper as it may collide with the object during insertion. We therefore compute the collision-free volume by subtracting a working area by the swept volume of the object. The final gripper shape must strictly lie inside this volume to ensure no collision. Since the skeleton is non-colliding, it lies strictly inside this volume and ensures that the three contact points and the robot arm are connected as a single rigid component. We then perform topology optimization within the collision-free volume to obtain the final gripper design. We evaluated our algorithm on our own test suite of 23 objects, including objects that have internal structures, objects that cannot be picked up by antipodal grippers, the bunny, a subset of the well-known grasping dataset, and a set of challenging objects. Our algorithm found a solution to each of the 23 objects in our test suite and took less than 3 hours on average per object. While these generated grippers and trajectories are highly customized for each object, we can observe general patterns among these solutions. Looking at the gripper shapes, we can roughly classify them into 3 categories. Inserts take most of the load on a single point. Tongs support the object on both sides. and wrenches apply opposing torque to resist gravity. Looking at the trajectory, we can assign them to three general groups. Most trajectories approach the object from the front. Some trajectories approach the object from the side. And a few trajectories require complex twist motion to access the internal structures. Together, these results suggest that our algorithm is successful in understanding how each object needs to be grabbed. For example, objects with bilateral symmetry are grabbed using tongs on both sides. And objects with holes are grabbed by their holes using smooth insert trajectories. Note that although we can categorize the gripper designs and trajectories using simple labels, they are not trivial to be designed by hand because they can be sensitive to approach angle and sequencing. To bridge the virtual to reality gap, we 3D printed all the grippers and tested them on a URI5 robot. We tested picking up each object 10 times, and the results were promising. Of the 23 experiments, 21 lead to successful pickups. 17 of these experiments had a 100% success rate, and only 2 had success rates below 80%. The 2 failure cases were attributed to significant discrepancies in the 3D representation of the object. Since the algorithm was operated on the wrong input, the generated grippers and trajectories did not work well in practice. For the 2 objects with poor success rates, our algorithm chose the contact locations that do not leave much room for misalignment. The grasp location, the motion of the robot, and the positioning of the object must be very precise at the sub-millimeter level. These results, along with the discussion of the failure cases, show that our method is highly reliable in the real world and provide exciting avenues for future research. The most evident direction is to improve the way we measure stability of a grasp to account for misalignment. Future work could also incorporate dynamic analysis after the object has been grabbed to further expand the set of passively graspable objects. While our algorithm successfully finds a gripper for the top key, it would be interesting to investigate alternatives that jointly optimize the contact point selections and the trajectory for more restricted cases. In addition, future work could optimize for a single gripper that could handle 2 or more objects to further improve versatility and reduce fabrication cost. In summary, we presented a generative design framework for passive grippers. As we saw during the COVID-19 crisis, the ability to repurpose a manufacturing line can be a matter of life and death due to sudden changes in demand. Our custom 3D printable passive grippers allow existing robotic systems to easily adapt to pick up different objects without the need for additional programming or system complexity. We address the challenges of exploring the huge design space with our key insights on representation, abstraction, and co-design. Finally, we validated our algorithm with extensive physical experiments and showed that our method is highly successful. Being in an early stage, our work opened up several exciting directions for future research, and we hope that this work will enable a future where manufacturing lines can be retooled to address our most critical needs in future crises.